could have altered a human to that extent. I wonder what is going on here.
No hitting the colonists, even if the Thorian makes them fire on us. That's what the gas grenades are for.
As you order, Commander Shepard.
tried to fight it, but it gets in your head. You can't imagine the pain. I was supposed to be their leader. These people trusted me. It wants me to stop you, but I won't. I won't!
All right, we just need to find this creature and determine what it... That is disturbing.
That does not look like any plant I've ever seen. This may be problematic.
Invaders, your every step is a transgression. 1,000 feelers appraise you as meat, good only to dig or decompose. I speak for the old growth as I did for Saren. You are within and before the Thorian. It commands that you be in awe.
You gave something to Saren, something I need.
Saren sought knowledge of those who are gone. The old growth listened to flesh for the first time in the long cycle. Trades were made. Then cold ones began killing the flesh that would tend the next cycle. Flesh fairly given. The old growth sees the air you push as lies. It will listen no more.
Give me what I need and I'll strike back at the one who betrayed you.
No more will the Thorian listen to those that scurry. Your lives are short, but have gone on too long. Your blood will feed the ground in a new growth!
Thank you.
more and it will be severely hurt.
Not the time!
A few more and it will be severely hurt.
Shh. Thank you.
I'm free. I suppose I should thank you for releasing me.
How did you end up inside that thing?
My name is Shiala. I served Matriarch Benezia. When she allied herself with Saren, so did I. Benezia foresaw the influence Saren would have. She joined him to guide him down a gentler path. But Saren is compelling. Benezia lost her way.
Are you saying Saren can control minds?
Benezia underestimated Saren, as I did. We came to believe in his cause and his goals. The strength of his influence is troubling.
Benezia sought to turn the river and was swept away.
Asari matriarchs are among the most intelligent and powerful beings in the galaxy. How could one fall under Saren's control?
Saren has a vessel, an enormous warship unlike anything I've ever seen. He calls it Sovereign. It can dominate the minds of his followers. They become indoctrinated to Saren's will. The process is subtle. It can take days, weeks, but in the end, it is absolute. I was a willing slave when Saren brought me to this world. He needed my biotics to communicate with the Thorian, to learn its secrets. Saren offered me in trade. I was sacrificed to secure an alliance between Saren and the Thorian.
Then why were the Geth trying to destroy the Thorian?
After Saren had what he needed, the Thorian became a liability. Saren knows you are searching for the conduit. He knows you are following his steps. He attacked the Thorian so you could not gain the cipher.
What's the cipher? And why did Saren need it?
The beacon on Eden Prime gave you visions. But the visions are unclear, confusing. They were meant for a Prothean mind. To truly comprehend them, you must think like a Prothean. He must understand their culture, their history, their very existence. The Thorian was here long before the Protheans built this city. It watched and studied them. When they died, it consumed them. They became a part of it.
So the Thorian taught Saren to think like a Prothean. How?
The cipher is the very essence of being a Prothean. It cannot be described or explained. It would be like describing color to a creature without eyes. To understand, you must have access to endemic ancestral memory, a viewpoint spanning thousands of Prothean generations. I sensed this ancestral memory, the cipher, when I melded with the Thorian. Our identities merged, our minds intertwined. Such knowledge cannot be taught. It simply exists.
I need the cipher.
There is a way. I can transfer the knowledge from my mind to yours, as I did with Saren. Try to relax, Commander. Slow, deep breaths. Let go of your physical shell. Reach out to grasp the threads that bind us, one to another. Every action sends ripples across the galaxy. Every idea must touch another mind to live. Each emotion must mark another's spirit. We are all connected. Every living being united in a single, glorious existence. Open yourself to the universe, Commander. Embrace eternity. I have given you the cipher, just as it was given to Saren. The ancestral memories of the Protheans are a part of you now.
Are you all right? What just happened?
I saw something. It still didn't make any sense.
You have been given a great gift, the experience of an entire people. It will take time for your mind to process this information.
We should get you back to the ship where you can be monitored.
I am sorry if you have suffered, but there was no other way. You needed the cipher. In time, it will help you understand the vision from the beacon.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the Thorian?
When the creature enveloped me, I became part of it. But I still don't truly understand it. So alien, so ancient. Its exact age is impossible to know. It measured time differently. 10,000 years of hibernation broken by a few frantic centuries of activity. Its mind was awesome, magnificent. It transcended all classification. And now it is gone.
Don't tell me you feel sorry for that thing.
The Thorian was a unique life form. A sentient being that lived for 50,000 years, maybe more. There is nothing even remotely like it in the known galaxy. I am grateful you saved me from a life of thraldom. Yet I cannot help but feel some sorrow for the loss of such a rare and remarkable creature.
I want to know more about Benezia.
Benezia was greatly respected among our people. A powerful biotic, even for an Asari. She was widely known as a teacher of philosophy and religion. She always sought the paths of peace and harmony. She joined with Saren because she hoped to turn him away from his path of destruction.
Instead, she became one of his most powerful allies.
As I mentioned before, Matriarch Benezia underestimated Saren. Be sure you do not make the same mistake.
Tell me more about this ship Saren has.
Sovereign is alien. I do not know how it was built or where it comes from. Its design does not match that of any known spacefaring species. It dwarfs any vessel in the Citadel or Alliance fleets. Its weapons are devastating. Its defenses, virtually impenetrable. With it, Saren believes he is unstoppable.
You said Saren uses it to manipulate his followers.
The indoctrination. There is an energy about Sovereign. You feel drawn to the ship. It makes Saren's arguments more persuasive, more compelling. Spend enough time in Sovereign's presence and you will lose yourself. There is no other way to explain it.
I want to know more about you.
There is nothing remarkable about me. I was merely one of Matriarch Benezia's disciples. For nearly 2 centuries, I followed her, learning at her feet. When Benezia revealed her plan to join Saren, she gave her disciples a choice. Only those who were willing had to follow her. Many felt her plan was too dangerous. But I believed in her. I thought she could turn Saren away from his insanity. Instead, we joined him in it.
Now that you're free of the Thorian, what are you planning to do next?
If you allow it, I would like to stay here with the colonists. They have suffered greatly, and I played a role in their suffering. I would like to make amends.
The colonists will need all the help they can get. They'll be happy to have you on their side.
Thank you, Commander. May fortune smile upon you.
You did it. With the Thorian gone, we can start rebuilding for ourselves again. And we're free of Exogeni's threats. We're back to being just a little nowhere colony. Thank you, Commander.
I was hoping you'd have a moment to speak with me. I've got
What do you need?
I need to retrieve some data. It's not a big job, but it pays well.
Sounds easy enough. What's the catch?
No catch, really. It's dangerous work, but not for someone like you.
People are quick to assume we enjoy being in hazardous situations.
It's not that bad. Really. All you need to do is find my console at Exogeni headquarters and drop the data onto this OSD. It's that simple.
I'll look around if I get the chance.
I appreciate it. That data could be worth a lot of money. Just come and see me when you've got the data.
Time to get moving.
Just keep in mind what I said. Any luck finding my workstation out in the ruins?
Why work in the middle of nowhere if your skills are so useful?
Maybe I've got a bit of the frontier spirit in me. That, and the alternative is a bit too secure for my liking. Freelancers don't have to worry about security as much, so long as we keep a low profile.
Tell me about the data I'm getting for you.
Plans for a few prototype mods? I'm a freelancer. Some of my mods are highly sought after.
Time to get moving.
Just keep in mind what I said.
It'll be tough going, but we'll make the...
I will do what I can to assist the colony in this difficult time. I am ashamed of the damage done to the lives of these people.
Farewell, Shiala.
Farewell, Commander. I wish you well in your hunt.
I fought so hard, but any thought of my own caused so much pain.
I never thought I would be so thrilled to see a soldier. Forgive my previous inaction, but under the Thorian's influence, every thought was examined and filtered.
What will you do now that the fighting is over?
I may stay, try to recover my losses. I can have new supplies delivered within weeks. Perhaps the colony will survive after all.
Let me see what you have in stock.
Of course. Return in the future, and I may even have more to see.
Doesn't hurt anymore. I can think my own thoughts again. We have a chance to start over, thanks to you. Food is still our immediate concern, but we'll manage.
I took out what looked like the oldest of the Varren. The rest are yours.
That's great. I mean, Varren tastes horrible, but with the Geth gone, I can organize a hunt. Thank you for not abandoning us like everyone else.
I should go.
Here, for your trouble. It's not much, I know, but it's all we can spare.
Finally, that damn thing is out of my head. I can think without pain. I still need the power cells for this generator, though. I found these power cells in the tunnels. Are they what you're looking for?
I knew they'd turn up eventually. Here, Fidan gave me some requisition money. It's all yours. Now if I can kick these power cells into place, I'll have this colony up.
Have you given any thought to helping us with our water troubles?
The water's back on again.
Really? I'll need to get the relays going then. Thanks for Here's a small payment for your trouble.
Thank you for freeing me.
I hope Exogeni learned their lesson.
Thank you for everything.
I'm free. Thank you for giving me my mind back.
Thank you for everything you did.
Thanks, Commander.
I have my own thoughts.
They tell me you... Pharaoh.
The only thing I can say about that plan is made me forget how hungry I am. Thanks for getting me these power cells.
Oh, it will take time for things.
The Thorian forced me to think what it wanted. I felt when you killed it.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination.
Commander, you look pale. Are you suffering any ill effects from the cipher?
I just need some time to let this cipher do its thing.
I might be able to help you. I am an expert on the Protheans. If I join my consciousness to yours, maybe we can make some sense of it.
Do it. Hurry. We don't have much time.
Relax, Commander. Embrace eternity! That was... incredible. All this time, all my research, yet I never dreamed. I am sorry. The images were so vivid. I never imagined the experience would be so... intense. You are remarkably strong-willed, Commander. What you have been through, what you have seen, would have destroyed a lesser mind.
Did you see anything?
The beacon on Eden Prime must have been badly damaged. Large parts of the vision are missing. The data transferred into the Commander's mind is incomplete.
You sure you didn't come across any kind of clue or hint? Something we might have missed?
Everything I saw, you already know. You were right about the Reapers. The Protheans were destroyed by a race of sentient machines. I think it is obvious there is a connection between the Reapers, the Prothean extinction, and the Conduit. But I did not see anything that would help us find it.
What's our next move?
I was able to interpret the data relayed through your vision. What was there, at least. But something was missing. Saren must have the missing information. Maybe he found another beacon. If we can find the missing data from your vision, I can... Oh. I am sorry. The joining is exhausting. I should go to the medical bay and lie down for a moment.
Dr. Chalkwash should take a look at you.
That will not be necessary. I just need some rest. Somewhere quiet.
We're done here. Dismissed.
I've sent off the Pharos report, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
Commander, Exogeny should have told us about the Thorian. It would have made your job much easier.
You might have been able to capture it for study instead of destroying it.
Exogeny tried to study it. Look how that turned out.
Perhaps it's for the best, then. At least the colony was saved.
Of course it was saved. Shepard would go to any lengths to help a human colony.
I never jeopardized the mission.
That's good, Commander. Stopping Saren is your primary goal. Everything else is secondary.
Goodbye, Commander. We will be waiting for your next report.
Equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere. Logged. The commanding officer is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
That thing got into my head pretty deep.
It will take time for things to get...
Thanks for getting me these power cells. Hopefully I can get this damn thing working.
Thank you for everything you did.
Good timing, Commander. We got a transmission coming in from the Citadel. Top priority clearance.
I'll take it in the comm room.
Commander Shepard, we've received information that may be critical to your mission against Saren.
I'll take all the help I can get.
We've received an urgent message from one of our infiltration regiments in the Traverse.
You mean spies?
Spectres tend to attract attention, Commander. But they are only one arm of the Council. Special task groups are often a better option for monitoring developing situations.
We currently have several infiltration units scattered throughout the border regions of Citadel space. This particular unit was gathering intel on Saren.
What did they find?
Unfortunately, the message we received was little more than static. The infiltration team must be in a situation where they can't set up proper interstellar communications. But the message was sent on a channel reserved for mission-critical communications. Whatever they were trying to tell us, we know it was important. Considering your interest in Saren, we thought you might want to investigate this. Find out what happened to our team. The signal originated from the planet Vermeer.
I'll look into it.
The Council prefers not to become involved in the specifics of Spectre activities. We only want you to be aware of all your options, including Vermeer. Good luck, Commander Shepard. We will keep you advised if we learn anything else.
Commander, what can I do for you?
Something bothering you?
It's Saren. I'm starting to wonder whether we'll ever find him. He's always one step ahead of us, and he's got those damn Geth.
We're getting close, Garrus. We'll find him.
I wish I had your confidence. I just can't stand the thought of him getting away with everything he's done. I know you're doing everything you can, and if anyone can catch him, it's you. But if there's anything else I can do to help, anything, just tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it.
I understand your concern, but we will find him. Just make sure you're ready to go when we do.
Yes, ma'am. You can count on me. Thanks for hearing me out. I appreciate it. Can I ask you something, Commander?
What is it?
Are you worried that the Council might be protecting Saren? I mean, they were really dragging their heels before. What if we find him, bring him back to the Citadel, and they refuse to act?
I get the feeling this isn't a question. Speak your mind, Garrus.
Well, maybe we shouldn't give them the chance, Commander. In my opinion, Saren's too dangerous to be kept alive. Too much could happen. He could escape, or the Council might let him go. If we find him, when we find him, I say we make sure we stop him permanently.
If Saren won't listen to reason, if he forces my hand, I'll kill him in a heartbeat. But only if it's absolutely necessary.
But what's the point in keeping him alive? It just gives him an opportunity to escape or convince the Council to listen to him. And what about the Geth? They might try to free him.
We know more about Saren's plans than anyone, but what do we really know? If we just kill him, we lose the chance to find out.
Yeah, I see your point. Do you really think there's more to know, other than the fact that he's a raving lunatic?
Maybe, maybe not. But it's not a chance I'm willing to take.
Yes, ma'am. Commander, good to see you.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you got.
You bet, Commander.
Looking for supplies? Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you...
You bet, Commander.
Thank you.
Looks like we've got an active distress beacon on the planet below, Commander. No message, just a locator signal.
Thank you. Rescuers? Oh, thank God. See? I told you somebody would come to investigate that signal. My name is Dr. Ross, Chief Exogeny Researcher at this facility. We've been trapped in this room for days. We're almost out of food and water. You got here just in time.
I need to know what's going on. Why is this place crawling with Thorian creepers?
How do you know about the Thorian?
I know what Exogeny was up to. I saw what they let the Thorian do to those colonists, so I destroyed it.
Our secret's out then. No point in my lying. You already know the worst. The creepers here were created using altered samples from the specimens on Pharos. We discovered a way to turn them into docile, obedient servants. Everything was going fine until a few days ago. Then all the creepers suddenly went berserk. Only a handful of us made it back into the safety of this room.
Any idea why they turned on you?
Maybe there was still some kind of link between the creepers and the Thorian back on Pharos. The Thorian was unlike any other life form we've ever studied. I can't explain how, but maybe when it died, it somehow set off the creepers here.
I've heard all I need to.
Look, I know what we did here was wrong. I'll admit that. But it's over now. There's no sense reporting this to the authorities, right?
Maybe we can work something out.
Normally, Exogeny would have my back, but it sounds like they're going to have their hands full cleaning up the mess on Pharos. But I've got money. A nice little emergency fund I set up. It's yours if you let us go.
Deal. Get the hell out of here.
You made the smart choice, Commander.
Thank you. Thank you. We'll be right back.